Many people hate to get up in the morning. It's a scientific fact. I mean, we'll hit the snooze alarm and then try to just get a few more winks while listening to the radio. But did you ever think about the people on the other side of the radio? The ones that get up so early so that you get to listen to them? Well, I decided to go and see what goes on the other side of the radio.
I snuck in to visit Greg and Courtney, the morning team at WHEB 100.3 FM in Portsmouth, New Hampshire. If you think it's pandemonium on the air, you should see what goes on behind the scenes while the songs are playing.
You ready?
What we do is we record callers on tape. That way you can control pretty much what they say, and that way they don't swear and get you in any trouble or anything like that. And you can also pick out the better quality of calls when you're doing a contest.
And then we
letting people
call
on the air live can sometimes be dangerous and hazardous to one's broadcasting career. Now we're going to take this tape and play it back like it was live. The listener will
never know.
Here we go.
I felt like I was being let in on a big secret. Things just aren't the way you think they are on radio.
And we have Doug on the phone. And Doug, are you ready to go, Doug? Okay, so we'll just let that play, and this is what he's doing. So you can...
Doug called in to gargle a song for Greg and Courtney, and they had to guess what song it was.
This should be titled, What People Will Do for a Prize. Wild Thing.
That's right.
Hey!
If you want to wake up and gargle that tune. Nice
good
job,
huh?
Thank
you. Yeah,
I can't believe you sounded good, actually. It was really good.
It
didn't sound like Wild Thing, Yvonne?
What is it? Like Shelley Winters. I'm sorry.
It sounded like...
Besides the name of Japan, my heart. All right, we have, folks, we have 58 degrees.
It sounded like a lot of fun, but there had to be some drawbacks to this job.
What's it really like getting up this early in the morning every day to do radio
What's
for thousands
really
of
one
people?
One word, Court?
No, do you want to answer them? I don't think I should answer. I can't say the word on the
air. One word together, Court?
Yeah.
Ready? One,
two, three. Socks. Yeah, it really does.
It's
early, very early.
You know, last night I went to bed at just before 9 o'clock and it was still light outside.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what we're talking about here, you know? I didn't even make it through The Simpsons. Oh, is that on this network?
And Greg and Courtney seem to get all sorts of really funky celebrity callers.
Hello, Elvis, are you there?
Hey, Bill. What? How you doing? It's me, man.
Elvis, what's going on? It's not...
Well, I'm Mr. Donahue. I just had a call up about your topic, lesbian Nazi construction workers on the middle of them.
Elvis, it's me, buddy. Me?
Well, I know it's you, Phil. Listen, man, you got one of those 7-second delay things? I can't hear myself on the air.
And Elvis, it's me!
Your topic is supposed to be on the new healthcare system, Elvis.
You know what, Mr. Donahue? It's really funny, man. Because I was supposed to do a report.
Yeah.
On the same topic for this DJ friend of mine.
Oh, really?
I'm gonna blow him off, man.
Yeah.
Man, what a dork.
Elvis, this is not Phil Donahue, it's me.
You know the dork, Elvis?
Elvis.
Hey, man, what are you going on Donahue?
Elvis, I'm not on Donahue, all right?
Elvis, you dialed the wrong number, you're in a lot of trouble.
Forget about it.
Oh, man. I'm going to stay with AT&T, right?
Yeah, you should have stayed with AT&T. Forget it, Buck. Yeah, the picture's out. Yeah. Bye, Elvis, and we'll be back right after this.
I asked Courtney, what are all those things on the wall?
These are all the CDs we play on the air. And what they are is this is a CD rack, and they're all in alphabetical order, so they're easy to find. And they're also numbered, like L5 is Led Zeppelin, so if you look on the music log and it says you need to play L5 Led Zeppelin, you just look for L5, pure and simple. And I'm putting them away, and then what we have to do is pull the next shift CDs.
Courtney, good move on the...
Greg and Courtney obviously have too much time to think in the mornings.
How come mimes can't get out of the box?
You ever wonder if swimming's so good for you? Why are whales so fat?
What happened if nobody wanted to run for president? Would we have a president?
Why do you have to wash a raincoat?
Why
does
sour cream have an expiration date?
You've got a point there. Just some imponderables from us. The kind of things we think about while we're rocking
it's
America.
It's a reminder during the day.
I feel good.
I gotta murder you.
TGIF. Thank Greg, it's Friday.
After listening to Greg and Courtney, I have to admit, listening to morning radio will never be the same.
For Community Chronicles, I'm Tom Giarrosso.